Welcome to Alanis Business Academy. I'm Matt Alanis, and this is How to Calculate a Payback Period with Inconsistent Cash Flows. In our last video, we learned about the payback period, as well as how to calculate the payback period assuming consistent cash flows. For access to this video, select the link above, or go to the Alanis Business Academy YouTube channel page and search for the video titled How to Calculate the Payback Period. Unfortunately, cash flows are anything but consistent, which makes the basic formula for calculating a payback period somewhat unhelpful. So in this video, we're going to walk through how to calculate the payback period when our expected future cash flows fluctuate from one period to the next. The formula to calculate the payback period, assuming inconsistent cash flows, is A plus the result of B divided by C. This probably makes little sense at this point, but let me attempt to elaborate. In this formula, A represents the last period with negative cash flow. Essentially, this is the period just before we recover our initial investment. B represents the amount of cash that is remaining at the end of A. C represents the total amount of cash generated in the period immediately following A. If this is still somewhat unclear, that's okay. It'll make a lot more sense once we work through a problem. Let's assume that we'll be investing $9,000 in a project. This is our investment, so we include the $9,000 in parentheses, which represents a negative figure or cash outflow. The abbreviation CF stands for cash flow, and the subscript 0 indicates the period. A period of 0 represents the present time. Assume that, based upon our calculations, that we project to receive positive cash flows of $2,000, $2,500, $3,750, and $4,500 in periods 1 through 4, respectively. When calculating the payback period for inconsistent cash flows, I find it helpful to use a two-column approach. The first column contains our expected cash flows in order from when we expect to receive them. The second column contains the remaining cash needed to cover our initial investment of $9,000. Now that we've organized our problem, we simply need to subtract each of our expected future cash flows from our initial investment. So in the first period, we subtract $2,000 from $9,000 to get $7,000. This means that after the first period, we still need $7,000 to cover our initial investment. In the second period, we subtract our expected cash flows from year 2 of $2,500 from our remaining unrecovered investment of $7,000 to get $4,500. For year 3, we subtract expected cash flows of $3,750 from $4,500 to get $750. At this point, we only need $750 in positive cash flow to break even and cover our startup costs of $9,000. Now in year 4, we expect to receive $4,500 in cash, which is much greater than the $750 needed to recover our initial investment. Since we will experience positive cash flow in year 4, year 3 represents the last period that we will have negative cash flow. As a result, year 3 represents A. So already, we know that our payback period is going to be somewhere in between 3 and 4 years. Now that we have A, we need to see if we have enough information to solve this problem. Once again, B represents the amount of cash that is remaining at the end of A. Since we know that A is period 3, or the third year, and the corresponding cash remaining at the end of A is $750, $750 will be used as B. The last variable in our formula is C, which represents the total amount of cash generated in the period immediately following A. This is $4,500. Since we expect to receive $4,500 in cash at the end of year 4, and year 4 is the period immediately following A. At this point, we simply substitute these values into their corresponding variable and solve. Doing so gives us a payback period of 3.17 years, or 3 years and 2 months if you convert the decimal into months. Whether this payback period is acceptable will depend in large part on the other opportunities that we have to generate positive cash flow. This has been how to calculate a payback period with inconsistent cash flows. For questions or comments, please utilize the comment box below, and I'll do my best to get back to those in a timely fashion. For access to additional videos on capital budgeting, as well as other business topics, be sure to subscribe to Alanis Business Academy, and also remember to like and share this video with your friends. Thanks for watching.